everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my Nora Roberts collection. This video was requested a little while ago and I finally decided to sit down and give you a big video wrap up of my Nora Roberts collection. I currently own 5 Nora Roberts standalones, but today I'm going to be discussing 9 Nora Roberts standalones, and I own 4 Nora Roberts books that are in a series. And unfortunately, I don't have a complete series from her. So first I thought we could discuss all of the standalone books that I've read by Nora Roberts. And these are kind of her standalone mystery books that I really enjoy. Of course, there's always romance involved because she is an adult romance author. But there's always something going on within the story, and it typically has murders, or the main characters being attacked or threatened. And then we have to kind of figure out who, is causing the threats or who's the killer. So the first book I'm going to talk about is Black Hills. This is my favorite Nora Roberts standalone book, and I did give this 5 out of 5 stars. We follow our two main protagonists, Lil and Cooper, and they meet in the country of South Dakota. Cooper is there visiting his grandparents, and Lil lives with her parents, and they meet at age 11, and as they get older, they kind of keep in touch, and they become really good friends, and then they become more than friends around age 18, and that's at the time when they are hiking in the mountains of South Dakota, and they come across a dead body, and this ends up being an unsolved murder mystery. After the age of 18, they kind of have a fallout. They each go their separate ways. Lil ends up staying in South Dakota, and she opens up a wildlife preserve for wildlife cats. Cooper ended up becoming a lawyer and a private investigator in New York, but 12 years later, Cooper ends up moving back to South Dakota to take care of his grandparents, and he runs back into Lil. Now, around this time, things start to get a little weird at Lil's wildlife park. Lil becomes the focus of these dangerous pranks, and Cooper ends up trying to figure out what's going on, and him and Lil end up realizing that what's going on now may have to do with the unsolved murder that they discovered 12 years ago. So the reason I loved this book so much, I'm a huge animal lover, so I really liked that aspect of the wildlife preservation. I also love books where the setting is set in the winter, and that's this book as well. And also the romance is a little bit more plausible between Lil and Cooper, because they did meet when they were 11 years old and they became friends, and then they had a little bit of a teenage romance. Then they finally, their paths meet back up again. They become more romantically involved, but they had that foundation 12 years ago. It wasn't so insta-love. Plus, I absolutely loved the characters. Cooper is hilarious. He is just so sarcastic, such a smartass. And Lil is very determined and headstrong. They're just two of my favorite Nora Roberts characters, and I loved both of their characters together. The next book I have is Angels Fall, and this is my second favorite, and I ended up giving it a 4.5 out of 5 stars. But we follow our main character, Reese, and she used to be a chef at a high-end restaurant, and one day there was a shooting in the restaurant and all of her colleagues were killed except for her. So she goes through intense years of PTSD and needing electroshock therapy. Her PTSD was so severe that she can't stay in one place. She has to constantly move around, otherwise she doesn't feel safe. Her car ends up breaking down and she ends up being stuck in this little town in Wyoming, and she takes a job there working in the kitchen of a restaurant in order to make a little bit of money to fix her car. Well, one day she is hiking and She witnesses a murder, so she reverts back into her PTSD. There is, of course, a handsome man named Brody who is a mystery writer. He kind of becomes a little bit entangled with Reese, and he tries to help her deal with what she saw, if she saw it, because now she's kind of believing that maybe she didn't witness the murder, maybe it was her PTSD, and so she's just trying to survive that. Now, the reason that this is my second favorite book is because the ending was so surprising. I was not anticipating the ending at all. So I think that definitely gives it like an extra point. I also think Reese's character is really interesting. Her PTSD is pretty intense. This definitely is more of a eerie book. And also, I really do like Reese and Brody. Their characters are fun to read, and I like their romance. And all in all, this was a really good book. The next book I have is Chasing Fire. And in this book, we follow our main character, Rowane. She is a fire jumper in Montana. So her job is to jump out of a plane when there is a wildlife fire, and she tries to put out this fire with her team. The book starts with Rowane and her partner going to a fire, and something terrible happens, and her partner ends up passing away. So the following year, they're doing new recruits, and we meet our love interest, Gulliver, and he is like a big shot firefighter who has decided he now wants to be a fire jumper. He also has an eye for Rowane. Now, as the book progresses, Rowane starts to be the target of these kind of vicious pranks at the camp, and also there are wildlife fires that occur that may not have been an accident. So her and all of her team, including Gull, are trying to figure out kind of what's going on, and she thinks it may have to do with her partner's accident that had happened like the past year. I do like the characters in this book. I love Rowane. She is quite refreshing, I feel like, a character. She is really strong, and she takes her job seriously. It's quite funny because she doesn't want to get interested in Gulliver. Like, he keeps, you know, like asking her out and kind of flirting with her, and she's not interested at all. Like, she is very focused on her work. And I also really like the relationship between Rowane and her dad. Her dad was a fire jumper, and I ended up giving this book a 4 out of 5 stars. Next, I have Hidden Riches. We follow our main character, Dora, and she owns a little shop of antiques, and one day she is at an auction, and she buys this interesting antique that ends up being smuggled. She becomes the target of an international criminal that deals with like antique smuggling. Now, of course, it wouldn't be a Nora Roberts book if we didn't have like our male interest, who is Jed, and he is Dora's neighbor. He used to be a police officer, but because of everything that's happening with Dora and the fact that she's gotten attacked in her store, he is roped back into like the line of duty to protect her. I also gave this book a 4 out of 5 stars. It was definitely different compared to the other books that I have just talked about. I liked the antique smuggling, and I also liked Dora and Jed's relationship. They definitely were not friends at first. Like, Jed didn't like Dora whatsoever. He really didn't want to get interested. It was definitely not insta-love between these two, so that's another reason why I really liked this book. The last standalone book that I own is The Witness, and I recently did a book review on this one, so I will link it down below. So I'm not going to go into too much detail about it, but basically our main character, Elizabeth, when she is like 18 years old, she witnesses a murder and she has to go into witness protection, but she ends up getting like found. So she runs away and she's living a life in hiding pretty much. She's very, very intelligent, so she's able to keep herself protected. She ends up living in this like tiny city. She becomes like the new interest of the sheriff. Then of course those that are after her figure out where she is, and once and for all she tries to pretty much rid herself of like this horrible past and make a new life for herself. This is one of the least favorite books that I've read by Nora Roberts. I ended up giving it, I believe, like a 3 out of 5 stars. I liked Elizabeth. I liked her character. It's very different than like the typical Nora Roberts character because she's very standoffish. She's very, very intelligent, very high IQ, but she's also more of like a robotic type of character. So she was definitely different. The male interest, Brooks, he was just kind of meh. Like, I liked him. He was really nice and he was funny. Their romance was more insta-love. If you liked this book and you haven't read any of the other books that I've talked about, I think you're gonna really, really love those because personally for me, this is one of the least memorable. Okay, so the other 4 books that I'm going to mention, I don't own. The first being Blue Smoke. And with this one, we follow our main character, Rena. She is an arson investigator, and when she was very little, she witnessed her family's restaurant get burned. So as Rena gets older, she becomes an arson investigator. Soon, there's all these like mysterious fires that kind of occur that start to connect to one another, and they start to connect to Rena, and she wonders if this has to do with, you know, the fire that ended up burning up her family's restaurant like all those many years ago. Now with this book, it's not very heavy on the romance. Of course there is romance involved, but it's mainly like Rena trying to figure out exactly what's going on with a little bit of romance like mixed in. And this was another book that I ended up giving like a 4 to a 4.5 out of 5 stars. The next book I'm going to talk about is Northern Lights. This is another one of like my top favorite Nora Roberts books. I think I gave it like a 4.5, close to a 5 out of 5 stars. Our main character in this book, Nate, he is a police officer and he moves to a small town called Lunacy in Alaska after his partner gets killed. So he takes the job as sheriff in Lunacy. And as he's like starting to learn his role as sheriff, he becomes interested in like the young pilot. Her name is Meg. One day a man is found in the mountains, and it turns out that this man was murdered like many, many years ago. There are more murders that happen in Lunacy. So Meg and Nate try to figure out this murder. The reason I like this book so much is because it is set in like the snow. I love that type of setting in a book. It's a little bit insta-love, but it's like plausible insta-love. With everything that like Nate has been through, it makes the like insta-love between him and Meg seem a little bit more plausible. The ending is so surprising. Like, I was not expecting who like the murderer was at all. So if you like that type of book, then I highly recommend this one. The next book I have is High Noon. And with this one, our main character, Phoebe, she is a hostage negotiator and she is the lieutenant at her precinct. So the story starts off with her negotiating to a man who is on the roof of a building and he is like wanting to jump off the roof. Well, Phoebe is trying to negotiate him to come down, which is how she gets to be involved with the love interest, because the man on the roof, his employer, Duncan, becomes interested in Phoebe. Now, later on, Phoebe gets attacked in her own precinct and she becomes the target of these threats, and she is trying to protect like her mother and her daughter while trying to figure out what is going on, and she thinks that it may have to do with a case that went wrong a long time ago. Now, this is kind of similar to like Blue Smoke and Chasing Fire, where like the main female protagonist is kind of trying to figure out what's going on and why she's being attacked, and then like the male interest is just there and supporting her. And this book I gave a 4 out of 5 stars. And the last book I'm going to talk about is Carolina Moon. This one I read a long time ago, so I don't remember too much about it, but I did give it like a 3.5 out of 5 stars. In this, our main female protagonist, Tori, she has like special powers where she can see visions, and as a child, she gets abused by her father for this. So the only thing that she has good in her life is her best friend, Hope. Now, one night, as Tori is getting beaten, she has a vision of Hope getting murdered. So after that, she escapes, you know, this little town where she grew up in. So many years later, as an adult, Tori ends up returning back and she wants to open up a shop, and she kind of starts becoming interested in Cade, who is Hope's older brother. Now that she's back in South Carolina, her and Cade try and figure out who Hope's murderer was all those many years ago. This book is definitely more creepy. I think the female protagonist, she wasn't that memorable of a character, and neither was Cade. So I think that's why I ended up giving it a 3.5 out of 5 stars, but it's been a long, long time since I've read that book. Maybe if I read it now, I'd give it a different rating, but that's kind of my opinion. Okay, so now we're going to jump in the books that I own that are in series. The first series I want to discuss is the Chesapeake Bay Saga, and that consists of Sea Swept, which is book one. I don't own book two and three, which is Rising Tide and Inner Harbor, and then book four, which is Chesapeake Blue. Now, these two are my favorite Nora Roberts books that I have read. I gave each of these books a 5 out of 5 stars, and I have reread these books multiple times. So the story starts out with three adoptive brothers, Cameron, Ethan, and Philip, and they make a promise to their father that they will take care of their newest adoptive brother, Seth, who is, I believe, 11 years old when the story starts, and the three brothers are now in like their late 20s, early 30s. So this entire series is pretty much about these brothers and learning to get along and trying to get custody of Seth. It has such a great message, and I really, really love this series. The first book, Sea Swept, is Cameron's story, and of course, in each story, there is a female protagonist, and with Sea Swept, we follow Anna. She is the social worker to Seth's case, and her and Cam become involved while they're trying to figure out like Seth's placement. In Rising Tide, we follow Ethan's story of how like all of this is happening, and the main female protagonist in that story is Grace, and she has a little daughter named Aubrey, who also kind of becomes involved. Then we have Inner Harbor, and that is Philip's take on everything, and the female protagonist in that story is Sybil, who actually ends up being Seth's aunt. So that's how she kind of becomes involved. Now, with Chesapeake Blue, this is Seth's story, but this is set many years later. So Seth is now 29, 30 years old, and he's finally coming home after becoming a very successful artist. And he has to deal with like his past coming back to haunt him. And the main character in this story, her name is Drusilla. She owns a little flower shop, and she kind of gets entangled with like the Quinn boys as well. I also have Charmed and Enchanted, which is book 3 and 4 of the Donovan series. I read this a long time ago, and honestly, I didn't like it that much. I want to say the Donovan like family are witches. So with Charmed, we follow Anastasia, and she becomes involved with a single father. And with Enchanted, Liam Donovan is the main male protagonist, and he gets involved with a female protagonist named Rowan. I honestly don't remember much about it, but I do remember not liking it that much, so I think I ended up giving this to a 3 out of 5 stars, but also it's unfair because I didn't realize it when I bought this book that it was book 3 and 4, so maybe if I had read 1 and 2 first, I would have liked it a little bit more. It wasn't that memorable for me. And lastly, I have Savor the Moment, which is book 3 in the Bride Quartet. Once again, I haven't read book 1, 2, or 4, but I don't really think it would make that much of a difference. I didn't really like it that much. I think I ended up maybe putting it down. Like, as you can see, like, the spine's not even bent. This book looks brand new. Oh no, looky there. I never finished it. But basically, we follow our main character, Laurel, who is a baker, and she bakes wedding cakes with her partners, who run a, like, wedding venue. It's, like, about friendship and, of course, romance and drama. But I don't think there's, like, anything too dramatic that occurs in this book. Not like, you know, the standalone mysteries. All right, well, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if you've read any of these Nora Roberts books, or if you have the same opinions as I do. I hope you all have a great rest of the day, and I will see you next time in another video. Bye!